Ladies and gentlemen, can you hear me? Good evening. All right, listen, let's give a round of applause for this celebration. Before we do anything else, can you clap your hands because you're glad to be here? This is a mighty nice event. Don't you say so yourselves?
Yes.
And we have come to celebrate. I'm Arnell Morris, and I'm excited to be here with you today to celebrate these achievements for this man and woman of God. And so at this time, I'm going to ask y'all to help us. Do your feet feel okay?
Yeah.
We're going to stand on our feet because our honorees are about to walk in the building, and we want to receive them at this time.
God bless you, Mr. Michael and Andrea. We want to tell you from my wife and I that we honor you all. We've enjoyed this phenomenal birthday celebration. It was par excellent. Thank you for allowing me to be the MC, and we wish you all many, many more successes with your endeavors for the future. Blessings to you, and go and possess the land.
I want to give some beautiful facts about this man and woman of God. Are y'all ready to listen?
Yes.
All right, listen. Mr. Michael Myers, next to the youngest of 11 children. He grew up poor in Mississippi. He promised himself this: when I grow up, I'm going to have a bunch of cars and a bunch of trucks. Sounds like a young man. On October the 30th, 1996, he married his bride. And from their union, they have two children, Michael Myers Jr., age 15, and Chandrell, their bonus daughter, age 34.
Chad Myers, Brother Michael, we love you very much. It was an honor and a privilege to be here tonight. It was quite a worship celebration of everything that God's doing in your life, and we just thank you for the legacy that you're living and the legacy that you're leaving. God bless you. We love you from the Rudd family. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
For thine
Well, everybody know my wife turned 50. That's okay. My question is, when you get a day older or you're older, do you feel older? How does it feel getting older? But do you feel older?
No.
Is there one person in here who feels older, like, man, getting old? One hand, what are some of the things you do to not feel older?
Rest.
Enjoy life. Okay, what about laughing more? Laughter. Well, for anyone that doesn't know, we have a 15-year-old, Michael Myers Jr. And growing up, you know how we will often, you know, find the right childcare, right? You know, that's an unending search, the right childcare. It could be a family member or it could be a place of business. But it's a struggle, ongoing struggle. And the last thing you want to hear, something happened to your child, right? That's the last thing you want to hear. And it should be the last thing someone want to hear that in care, responsible for that child or children. So in our search to find, the ideal caretaker, care provider, Granny was one of the choices. Granny had participated. Thank you, Granny. But guys, I got to tell you, when your child is like really, really small, what's the age when kids start talking? I know for girls, it's what, like 3 months old, start talking? boys probably two years old. Okay, but you like, man, I can't wait till they start talking so they can tell it on somebody. Yeah. In particular, the child, the caretaker, right? You're like, man, when they can talk, they're going to tell it on you. Well, Mike told it on Granny. I was going home, picked up Mike from Granny, and whatever that age was, what, 2 years old when they started talking a little bit, for boys? I know it's younger, or older, younger, or something like that. But anyway, Junior said he was back there eating some Cheerios or something. I said, Mike, how was the day today? He said, it's fine. I said, what did you do? Not much, but Granny said, Granny says she's going to beat Zariah's ass. But I was a little shocked. I was shocked. Because he's still at that age where he's just beginning to talk, But, because he said it, with no hesitation. I couldn't believe what I was saying. I had to pull over a little bit. Like, Mike? Mike, what did you say? Of course, you have to still give him that baby talk. Mike, what did you just say? The granny said she's going to beat Zariah's ass. So you can't, say, Granny, don't do that again. Don't. One better than that. Granted, this one's on me, okay? How both parents want to be kind of equally as far as what the child's supposed to do? Can't go ask dad for something. Then he say no. Then he go ask mama. Well, Mike tried me. So he asked for something. I'm not sure what he was asking for, but he said, after he asked whatever he had to ask, I said, well, did you go ask your mom? So I want to make sure we're on the same page here. Mama said no, but She is the boss of you. I had to give him the baby talk again, but I'm telling you, I was swelling up. With the baby talk, I said, Mike, your mom is not the boss of me. Want to make sure we get that clear. You go tell your mama. You're not
the boss. Happy birthday, Shay. I'm so excited for you. I remember the first time I saw you, you were 3 months old, and now you're almost 50. I love you, and I wish you so many more, and happy birthday. Also, congratulations on your longevity, your marriage, as well as your business. Love you.
Happy birthday, A.T. Shay, baby. Good on your marriage, good on your business. Love you.
Turn this party up one time for Andrea Shay Myers. Amen. 32 years, listen to this, 32 years and counting to the U.S. Army. Here he is, the battalion chaplain to more than 600 soldiers. At the age of 17, she graduated high school a year early. They couldn't hold her no longer. And listen, she became an emancipated female by joining the Army. She is a master chef and a true Proverbs 31 woman.
Happy birthday, happy 50th birthday, little sister. Happy anniversary. Congratulations on your business. We love you.
Mama said, well, you know that's what she said, Shay. But first of all, congratulations to you and Mike on 26 beautiful years. And you raising little Mike well. Continue to do the things you do. Continue to do the things you do in the military. From one veteran to another, I love you, my sister. Peace.
Love you.
It's a really, really important story. I guess you guys said, I know they didn't let him up there again. Well, they did. I have the mic. I have proof. Want to share with everybody how my wife and I met. So I used to work out a lot. Used to. Met my wife. I saw her in the gym. Anybody remember a French Riviera spa? That was kind of like the spa back then. I'm not even sure if it still exists, but French Riviera Spa, that was the spa of spas. I was working out, so I had a workout buddy that was committed like I was, going to the gym religiously. I mean, it seemed like 7 days a week we were going to the gym. I mean, hitting it hard 7 days a week. So if you're going to the gym 7 days a week, it's hard to really miss too much, isn't it? If there is anything to see, you're probably gonna see it in that 7 days. But I saw my wife. My wife walked in the door. Guys, this is kind of crazy, but I'm sharing it with my family. Is that okay? This is a crazy story. She'll probably snatch the microphone at me when I go too far. But I want to share with everybody how we met. I saw her walk in the door. You know, I'm working out. And she caught my attention. I'm like, whoa. I can tell you the color of her workout outfit she had on. The top and the bottom. So she walked in with her friend. They came in. And of course, you know, being a gentleman, thought I was a gentleman. I didn't say anything to her. So I waited and waited and waited. Kept going to the gym though, every day. You know, didn't know what to say, by the way. I'm like, well, let me just watch her for a little while. Not stalk her, but let me watch her. So I was watching her, didn't miss anything. So I saw her go over there and start working out. I saw guys come over there and say something to her. I'm like, oh, this might not be good. Whatever she said to him, it wasn't good because they walked away. I'm like, my girl. So I'm walking kind of like behind her with my checklist. Like, check, okay, yeah, check. Check, all right, yeah, yeah, looks good. And because I knew I liked what I saw, but I knew when I saw her, though, it was way more than what I saw. But I knew it was a lot to it. I just didn't know the rest of it yet. So she constantly working out with a friend. The part that I liked the most is that she didn't notice me. That's the part I liked the most. I liked the fact that she didn't notice me. I'm like, check. So she wasn't like looking at the most buff got it going on person in that gym. So she didn't notice I was in there lifting all the weight they had. I like that part, so she got another check. That was like a bonus check. So one night when I got up the nerve to say something to her, I wasn't ready yet to say something, but I told my workout partner, this is true story now, the very first night she walked in the gym, I told my workout partner, looked over there at him, I said, hey, EJ, I said, you see that woman right there? That's gonna be my wife right there. And guys, I had a girlfriend at the time. Hey, that worked in that gym. Yeah, you talk about bold. That was pretty bold. I mean, I was willing to get hurt. You know, if I had to get hurt in that gym that night, I was willing to get hurt. She wasn't gonna get hurt, but I was willing to walk out limping if I had to. But the night that I got up enough nerve to say something to her, I didn't. I said something to her friend. I said, hey. You're a friend? I said, yeah, she said, well, hang on a minute. She said, let me let you meet her. I said, oh, no. I'm not ready to meet her. I don't know what to say. She's like, well, just hang on. So she walked out of the dressing room. She said, hey, Mike, this is Andrea. Well, she may have said Shay, because I don't ever call her Shay. She said, Shay, this is Mike. That was about the extent of my conversation. That's why, hey. I wouldn't dare ask her for a number. I wasn't gonna go there. I'm like, oof, if I called her, I wouldn't know what to say. But she had me just like that because I'm telling you, it was a challenge for me to really identify the fact that, hey, there is a woman out there for you. And I'm talking about marriage material. I found out quickly that she was marriage material, quickly. And I appreciate her for that. She was saved when I met her, and obviously still saved. I'm not sure where I was, but I know I was nowhere close to where she was. But for me to make those kind of adjustments, I'm like, boy, you are whipped if this is where you are, because she changed me to the person where I am today. And I'm telling you, the number of years that we've been married is, let me get it right, 26?
Yay!
26 years. Guys, I would do it all over again if I had to do it over. I mean, in a heartbeat, I'd do it all over again.
Shay, I was just wanted to wish you a happy 50th birthday. Enjoy and have many, many more. And congratulations on your 25th wedding anniversary as well. And you and Mike are doing a great job. And I look to see you up soon.
I just want to say I enjoyed myself and just want to say happy anniversary and happy birthday to both of you guys.
And happy anniversary. All right.
Hello, family. So, many of you have seen the comedy show Martin, right? And so, in many of those episodes, I think one in particular, there's an episode where Martin tells his version, and Gina tells hers, and Tommy tells his, and everybody has their version. Well, he got it mostly right.
Every time I look around, there she is.
So he mentioned that he had a girlfriend. Well, you know, I was in the gym truly to work out, and I wasn't looking for anybody. As a matter of fact, I was just getting rid of somebody. And, you know, I promised God, I said, Lord, if you get me through this, I promise you I'm going to hear and listen to what you have to say, because marriage is for a lifetime, and that's the way I looked at it. And I was coming out of a divorce, and not that I hated men or anything like that, it's just that when I made those vows, I was real serious. I was very serious, and you know, in that previous situation, the Lord had told me no, and I disobeyed. And so for God to give me another chance, and I'm real grateful for that. And so I wasn't looking, and we're not supposed to be looking no way. You know, the Bible says that he that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. So let him find you. Don't go looking for him. Because you're worth being apprehended. And when you know who you are and whose you are, you won't receive anything. Because he's all of that. He is a provider, the best father, the most handsome. He was the most handsome man in the gym. I saw him. I saw him every day. Yeah, and see, I had to, you know, I am from South Memphis, right? Orange Mound, Bethel Grove Mound. And so that thing he was dating. Too many times, and yes, she did, sis. I'm with family, right? So, big booty, Annette was her name, big booty Annette. Anyway, so she came up to me and she asked me a question, and I said, the only man I'm interested in is Jesus. And then she, approached me again. I thought the only man you were interested in was Jesus. So he had to get rid of her. And 26 years later.
Happy birthday to my sister-in-law, and congratulations, happy anniversary. God has truly blessed you, your family, and has used your family to bless my family, and I really do appreciate that. Thank you for the invite. Everything was wonderful. You guys look great. I hate that we had to, you know, cut the evening a little short, but you know, these older people, sometimes they gotta take it in a little early. But you guys are magnificent. I am so ecstatic and happy to be a part of this family. And just keep doing those amazing things. I look forward to sharing with you on your new endeavors, with your new business and businesses that that you guys are working on. I know deep down in my heart that the future looks very bright for you and Mrs. Myers. Happy birthday, happy anniversary, and congratulations on all your accolades. We love you. All right.
Seeing you guys like this, but I think you both did great. I love you both. Kinda was the thing that birthed me, so I kinda have to be appreciative of it. I pray that you all get many, many more years.
Yeah, and then
there's
one more. Thank you. Dear Beloved, we're gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to renew the solemn and sacred vows that these couples have made when they first became husband and wife. So it is therefore my desire that you will recall the hour when the minister said to you that holy matrimony is an honorable estate instituted of God and signifying the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church and declared by Paul to be
Shay honorable. And Mike, I love you all. I had a blessed time tonight. And I wish you well on your success. God bless you. Love you.
Hey, Mike, brother-in-law. So thankful for you inviting me and everything, and hopefully see you on the next round.
Good night.
Say to you and Mike, congratulations on your 25 years of marriage. I think it's the most beautiful thing. Y'all was a beautiful couple. And I just love y'all so much. And I thank y'all for blessing me with my grandson. And I truly do appreciate the life that y'all live. Love you. God bless you.
Been such a blessing and such a journey, and you know, like we said, you know, people see everything right before them, but they don't know what happened to get it that way. So we're just so happy for you and just excited to know what God is going to do. We thank you for everything you've done, everything you're doing. We thank you for your being so compassionate, so giving, so loving, so understanding, so not being judgmental. Do I have a limit, time limit? And we've had an awesome time here, and just excited to see everyone in their Easter flock. But you know, it's just been a blessing, and congratulations on you all's business. Looking forward to seeing more to come of that anniversary. What else was, birthday. I'm not gonna say happy birthday to you until the 29th. Girl, you know I love you. I love you to pieces.
Amen. Happy birthday and happy anniversary.
What up, girl? All right, good.
Trading on the go? Well, there's none better than Partwit. Our platform is wide-ranging and allows you to buy, sell, trade various products, promote services, donate legal items, or part with, as we call it, as in receive parts of goods and services. We know that online trading and transactions can sometimes become misleading. We're keen on providing you with accurate information about the buyer and seller to warrant safety, enabling you to confidently and comfortably enjoy using the application. Our goal is to connect buyers and merchants around the globe, ensuring an experience of ease and efficiency as you shop or trade on the go. Not only will you be able to surf a great spectrum of products and services, but you will be notified when an item you're screening becomes available or the price is reduced. Could it get any better, really? Download Partwit now and have a great time trading on the go.